Hello guys, what's up? It's me again, Mr. Leonard, and today we'll be trying another code challenge. As you can see on my screen, this is the challenge that we are going to try today. Unlike the previous ones where we try code words, we'll still be using code words, hackerang, but each time I find a new interesting challenge online, I'll try to tackle the challenge and make a video while I'm tackling the challenge so that you can also learn. Palindromes defines a word, number, phrase, or another sequence of characters which reads the same backward as forward, such as madam. If you reach madam forward, it will be madam. If you read it backward, it will be madam. And race car or the number 1801, 1801, both forward and backward. So this is what palindromes generally are. There are many challenges that center around palindromes because it tests the programmer's knowledge of different functions, especially functions that deal with lists, and also how to use different loops such as for loop, while loop, etc. It also tests how they use their conditionals. Conditionals are just simple if statements: if this, do this, else, do this. But there's also else if, which is shortened in Python to elif. In this particular challenge, we have to write a function that will calculate the sum of all numeric palindromes that are less than n number. For example, if we have to calculate the sum of all numeric palindromes that are less than 10, since we have the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So these are all the numbers that are less than 10 right here. And interestingly enough, there are also palindromes, because if you read 1 forward and backwards, it will be 1 and so on to be 2 till we reach 9. So if we add 1 plus 2 plus 3 till 9, we are going to have 45. We can also use this as our test. We can say our function should return 45 when n equals to is equal to 10. We have two tests now. I hope you understood the challenge. Let me explain the challenge again. We have to write a function that will calculate the sum of all numeric palindromes that are less than n number. So if our n is 10, we have 45 as our sum to be 1 plus 2 plus 3 till 9. Well, it will give us 45. If our n is 10,000, we are to expect this. Also, we are looking at only numeric palindromes such as 1 to 9, 1 to 9, 11, 2 and 2, and so on, that are less than 10,000 or less than n. And our n will be 10,000. You can also code along or pause the video to try to answer it yourself, then check my results later. Without wasting more time, I'll begin to tackle the challenge. Let me just reduce this here so that you can look at the challenge while we code. I usually use IDO for simple tasks between 100 and 50 lines of code because it comes pre-installed with Python. Most of the other text editors that I have on my system usually take some time to load. I want this to be as simple as possible, not using all the functionalities that come with custom text editors. So we are going to use IDO and we are going to write a function. Let's define our function: sum numeric palindromes less than, so is it less than n? This is kind of a very long name for a function. Professionally, functions shouldn't have this kind of lengthy names, but I want to use this name so that at least we understand what the function is doing. And even if the length of the function name should not be long, it should be easily understood. You can't just define a function and call it n. It should be a name that someone can easily see and have an idea. Even if the person does not understand what the function does fully, when the person sees the name of the function, the person will have an idea about what the function is doing or is meant to do. Part of coding best practices is to use docstrings. When you write a function or classes in object-oriented programming, we usually use docstrings at the beginning of functions. This mainly serves as documentation for what a class does or a function does. In object-oriented programming, we use docstrings to document what the class does and maybe use normal code commenting with starting with the hash. And just write this function, etc. Here we use a doc string to document our function. This function returns this make palindromes. We can just bring it down. And then we should try to make sure that our code are in line, they align beautifully. So we have less than a number passed as n in the Once you see this function, you can quickly read this and understand, oh, this is what this function is going to do if I run it or if I use it in my code. So my first step is let's create a palindromes list. Let's create an empty palindromes list. So let's call it palindromes. So we have that. We have an empty palindromes list. What you want to do is to loop from 0 to n and then check the value of that number against its reverse form. So we can do for n in range n, so can do this if string n. What we are doing here is that we are checking the string form of n against the string form of the reverse n. So string is equal to string n, but we need its reverse form, and this is how to do it in Python. This thing right here will reverse anything. For example, something like A, B, C, D, and do this at the end. This is going to return D, C, B, A. So this is what we are basically doing here. It's going to return the string D, C, B, A. I'm just trying to explain to you what this thing right here does. So you can actually test it in your interpreter and make sure that it does what I'm saying it does. So if this is true, what you want to do is to add it into the palindromes. We add it into this list, palindromes n. We add the n into it. So what you want to do now is to return some palindromes. This function right here should do what you want to achieve. So let's print out this. We'll first try. You see why it's not best practices to use long names. I don't want to type everything again. Let's first try out the sum of palindromes 10. Let's save it on our desktop and call it T1. So we have it. Let's run. So we have 45 like we expected here. Less than 10 should return 45. Let's try 10,000 now. 10,000, yes. Let's save and now we run. And we have our result also 545,040. So we have 545,040. So that is basically how it should be done. This is the code that we want to use. This is the function that will answer this palindrome's challenge. But right now, I will try to refactor my code. So maybe, so we can maybe return some of a list. So inside the list, we have for n in range n if string n is equal to n. I'm trying to refactor my code here. Let's try this out. Hopefully we should get the same result. As you can see, we have the same result. Let's try it out for 10. As you can see, for 10,000, we have the same result as expected, and for 10, we also have the same result as expected. We have two solutions. The first solution is kind of wordy. Yeah, they are side by side. This is the first solution that we tried. It worked perfectly, but it is wordy. It has more lines of code than this one. This one only has one line of code, and it does everything it needs to do inside that one line. Using these one-liners to do what you want to do is actually better, especially if you have to write thousands and hundreds of lines of code. This kind of code right here might be more understandable for beginners, why this one might be a little bit jam-packed, but any professional Python programmer will understand this. Everything right here is all these lines combined together. What this one does is that it returns the sum of everything in this list right here, but this list is going to be generated by looping through the range of this n that is passed as argument, and then checking if the string of n is the same thing as the reverse of the string of n. This and this are the same, just that this is wordy and this one is a one-liner that does the same thing as this. Nobody will query you for choosing either of them. If you are a professional though, you might want to go for this kind of one-liner course. That is it for today. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to click like and subscribe. Also, don't forget to click the bell icon so that you'll be notified. See you next time.